Hello everybody, Jay Todd here at the Global Gaming Expo, and I've caught up with Industry Guru. That is your official title, right?
No, I tried not to go with that one.
All right, it didn't look good on the business card. This is Sue.
Instigator is what I chose, instigator.
Instigator, this is Sue Schneider, and she instigates things. And you're with Gambling Law Review, is that correct?
Yes, I now serve as Editor-in-Chief of Gaming Law Review.
Gaming Law Review. Wanted to make sure I got that right. You were moderating a session earlier on sports betting. Of course, sports betting is nothing new to the people in Europe, but over here, you didn't go to Nevada. I mean, it was, you know, not just a gray area, it was illegal. But all that's changing, and the American market is opening, and I think you're seeing sports betting perhaps be a catalyst to expanded online gambling in America.
It's possible. I think what's going to happen is, again, we could have as many as 20 states getting involved with sports betting. And one of the things that I've kind of consistently heard from people is that mobile probably will often be a part of that. You've got states like Mississippi that have passed it now, but they don't have mobile. But if you talk with people there, they're saying it's probably coming. So, I think what might happen is you might have states like Illinois and some other states who will maybe pass an omnibus bill that while they're passing sports betting, maybe they'll put in poker or casino on the internet. So, you know, it remains to be seen. I think we'll know more a year from now to see what sort of states have adopted this and at what mix of products they're going to allow.
True. It always seems like it's always just out of our vision what's coming until it gets here suddenly and quickly. But I know as an affiliate and former affiliate, I'm curious about the regulated American market and sports betting being a part of that. And there are some different opinions about how affiliates are going to play into a regulated market here in America. But in specific terms of sports betting, there's this huge black market and there's a huge offshore, quote unquote, illegal online gambling market. How do states bringing sports betting online now and perhaps affiliates who are thinking about marketing to them, how do they get those players away from sites like that?
Well, I think there's two questions. One is, can you migrate what I would probably in many cases consider a professional player who's been playing offshore? Because a lot of the more casual players kind of have dropped off as it's gotten harder to process payments and put money in and take money out. And I think it remains to be seen. People are saying that, you know, maybe 40-50% might migrate over into legal sports betting. But many of those guys are very price conscious, and if they can get a better deal at an offshore operator, it's kind of remains to be seen whether they will make that change. A U.S. operator, given the taxes that they're going to have on a state level and everything else, it's kind of hard for them to compete. So that's a big unknown. The second part of that is sort of the casual player, and will they get involved? And that's where I think, again, locally within the U.S. or domestically, that affiliates could potentially play a big role because may have been doing that. There was a discussion going on an affiliate session that we put together, and you know they were wondering about the regulation of affiliates in the U.S., and that's a big issue. And one of the discussions was about whether the U.S. regulators may have learned a lesson from the UK, and that's one of the reasons they're regulating to the extent that they are, to try to keep a handle on, you know, advertising or offers that may be made and things like that. But problems that they've had in Europe and in the UK in the past, try to keep those from happening here.
All right. So possibly, even though offshore sites could offer, say, bonuses and stuff that may entice players, a casual player, which will be your larger segment of the market, from an affiliate perspective, the opportunity could be there to help educate them that even though there might not be the same incentives as there are with some offshore illegal sites, that the regulated sites can offer security, the fact that they're fair payment processing. So there's an education process that affiliates could really use to their advantage.
Well, I think New Jersey found that out because they found that a lot of players were like, well, we didn't even know this was legal here. We didn't know how it was going to work. We didn't know it was going to tie in with the casino's loyalty programs, which is maybe could offset some of the pricing issues. So it gets complicated pretty quickly, but I think there's some opportunities there. Affiliates obviously have to weigh the cost of getting licensed, which can be substantial, versus, you know, do they want to continue to assist offshore sites? And that was another debate that was just going on in the session I just left, because New Jersey, for example, has taken the approach that, you know, you got to pick. You're either going to do offshore sites or you're going to do the legal regulated sites.
Well, I suppose that'll be a question that every affiliate will have to answer for themselves. But thank you so much. It's been an interesting, educational day, and you didn't instigate me.
Well, I'll have to keep trying.
Thanks for coming on.
Thank you.